Can everything I do be monitored at the router? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. The answer, of course, is yes, but it's actually more complicated than that. Let's get to the question first. A few days ago around the dinner table, my family was talking about how police can monitor everything you do on the web and track you. Because he is registered as the owner of the router, my father says that he can view everything I do as it passes through the router. Is this true? And if so, how can I bypass this? Like I said, the answer is yes, it is true. However, the pragmatic reality is that it's very difficult to do. Unless your father happens to be very technically inclined, it's not something that's in most people's wheelhouse. Let's talk about that, though, because it is one of the things that I refer to often, and that is simply that your ISP can see everything you do. In this case, in a sense, your father is your ISP. Whoever owns that router and its connection to the internet is providing you with the internet service. When you take a look at how your home computer is connected to the internet, your home computer or your mobile device, you're connecting to a router which then routes all the traffic to a similar kind of router at your ISP. The ISP specifically has higher-end routers, and they have tools and techniques that they can use to monitor the traffic that's going on across those routers. Now, while there are home routers that kind of sort of have similar technology, they have the ability to monitor what's going on, typically they're rare. You really do need to spend more money or get a higher end router in order to be able to actually monitor the traffic you have at home. However, as it turns out, there is an easy solution, a very inexpensive solution, if, again, your father is knowledgeable and motivated. And that's simply this. Instead of connecting your computer or your other devices directly to your router, the devices are connected first to a hub. A hub basically echoes everything that it gets on any port to every port. What that means is then that the computer being monitored is connected at one end, the internet or your router, your actual router, is connected at the other, and then on another connection, another computer is connected. That computer then runs what's called packet-sniffing software. The one most commonly used by industry professionals is something called Wireshark. It is very complicated to interpret the data. It's easy to set up. It's not really that difficult to set up at all, but it is interesting and difficult to interpret the data you see. The bottom line, though, is that somebody knowledgeable with this kind of a setup can relatively easily see everything that's going back and forth on the network. So, how do you protect yourself, be it from your father, from somebody else who's spying on you, from the ISP itself? Well, there are a couple of different things that, of course, are important. A lot of it is the same thing that you would do to protect yourself in a Wi-Fi hotspot, because we're facing pretty much the exact same scenario here. Somebody being able to examine or sniff your traffic as it crosses some device onto the internet. So, turn on your computer's firewall. Chances are it's already on these days, which is great. That's protecting you from malicious software and some other access mechanisms that might try and invade your computer directly. Use a desktop email program. Make sure that it's connecting to your email service using either SSL or TLS. Typically, this is the default configuration these days, but it is an option. And if you don't select it, everything you send back and forth in email is sent in plain text. If you used web-based email, or for that matter, anything else, make sure you're connecting via HTTPS. This, too, encrypts the information. People monitoring your traffic can see that you are connecting to this email service or that bank or whatever other site you're looking at, but they can't see the contents of the traffic that you're exchanging with those sites. And finally, consider using a VPN. Now, this is one of those things where if you really want to make sure that you are well and truly protected from somebody monitoring your internet conversations, then the only real solution, the only complete solution, is to use a virtual private network or VPN. This is software you install on your machine that encrypts all the data, everything, including what sites you're going to, and establishes a secure connection to the VPN service provider. So everything along that path between your computer and the VPN provider is completely encrypted. There is, of course, a catch. And that is, you need to trust the VPN provider because, once again, they kind of sort of become your ISP, and they then can see the unencrypted traffic as it leaves their servers. But in terms of actually keeping your information safe from somebody monitoring your computer at home, yeah, a VPN will protect you. Now, there are a couple of other things I want to point out here. One is, if somebody has physical access to your computer or your device, they can do whatever they like when you're not looking. And that could include installing what we might refer to as spyware, but what is often referred to as parental monitoring software. In other words, this is software that is marketed and designed for parents to be able to monitor what their kids are doing online. Of course, you don't have to be a parent to use it. You don't have to be a child to be monitored. So that's the kind of stuff that potentially could get installed. Hopefully, a good malware tool will identify that and remove it. But if you're ever uncertain, make sure your machine, your devices are physically secure. And finally, you mentioned in your question that the quote-unquote police can monitor everything that you do on the web and can track you. Once again, taken at face value, that sounds a little paranoid, and I want to address that. Literally, it is absolutely true. They can. But what's more important is understanding that they don't. Yeah, maybe in some countries and some jurisdictions they do. There are certainly scenarios where that's something that you might want to consider at higher risk than most folks. But the reality is, in most of the world, they simply do not. In fact, they need to get legal authority. They need to deal with the courts. In the United States, that means getting a subpoena or a court order in order to be able to monitor what's going on. Otherwise, by and large, you're just not that interesting. They have too many other things that they're trying to pay attention to. They have bigger fish to fry than what you and I are doing online. So again, while certainly it is possible that the authorities can monitor what you're doing, the pragmatic reality is they're not. Hopefully this helps. If you are concerned, make sure that you do scan your machine for malicious software, including monitoring software, and potentially use a VPN to make sure that whoever's controlling your router or installing other kind of network sniffing software can't see what you're up to. For updates, for comments, for related links, and more, visit askleo.com/4984. And if you're watching this on YouTube, be sure and check out the links in the description below. I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. Thanks for watching.